Rise and Fall of the Twisted Metal franchise, is it dead? Explained in detail. The gaming geeks in the 90s will surely remember the legacy of the Twisted Metal franchise. The first Twisted Metal game was developed by SingleTrac and published by Sony in 1995. It was a massive commercial success, striking the right chord with audiences. The game utilized aspects that were popular with the youth, and the concept of vehicular combat was loved by everyone. It sold over 11 million copies and made it to the greatest hits library of PlayStation. The series spanned 9 games that were made for PlayStation, PlayStation 2, PlayStation Portable, and PlayStation 3. It is hailed as one of the best and longest running PlayStation exclusive franchises. This game was made for those who had a desire for destruction. The different installments mostly shared a similar theme, where the playable character would have to participate in the eponymous Twisted Metal competition, basically a crazy demolition derby. The contestants would be competing in some uniquely designed vehicles that could shoot missiles and machine guns to destroy the others. The players had to choose a vehicle in the arena where they wanted to play, then they fight it out with the opposing drivers. There were pickups scattered throughout the stage, allowing you to utilize the finest of missiles and landmines against the other drivers. You even had repair stations to regenerate your health, and when the health bar ran too low, you lost. The last one standing would win, and the grand prize was a reward from the legendary Calypso. This man lives beneath the streets of Los Angeles the whole year, and then holds the competition where he grants the winner anything he desires. There is no limit on the price, size, or even the reality, which means that the death combat has a lot at stake. Twisted Metal was a test of your skills, and while the strategy element might have been restricted to a bare minimum, you still needed to exercise quick thinking to get the better of your enemies. Your gameplay skills had to be perfect to ace the challenge, and if you wanted the ultimate dream fulfilled, you would have to deserve it. In this video, we will focus on the rise and fall of this popular franchise. How could one of the most popular games fall by the wayside over time? What went wrong? Deteriorating the standard of the game to the point that it eventually scarred its rich legacy? This video will have all these answers for you and more.
Calypso, you are coming with me!
Minion, it's so good to see you again!
The rise of the Twisted Metal franchise. The series started with a bang when Twisted Metal was released in 1995. A very satisfying and much improved sequel followed, ensuring that the franchise was all set out for glory. Gamers were excited about something special, and initially, the series did everything to live up to the hype. Let us take a quick look at some of the Twisted Metal games over the years. Twisted Metal 1995. Let's dive into the very beginning, when the first Twisted Metal game was released in 1995. It was developed by SingleTrac and produced by Sony Interactive Studios America. The publishing sector was handled by Sony Computer Entertainment, and the game was released for PlayStation. The story of the game is set on Christmas Eve 2005, when the challengers take each other on in the streets of Los Angeles. Calypso organizes the competition every year, taking place in and around the city. Various drivers are invited for the event, and they have to compete for the grand prize, which is anything they want. The contestants who are selected get an email that simply reads, "Will you drive?" in red letters. The game is all about the best driver, who could survive until there is nobody else left. There is a funny story about how this game was conceptualized. The developers were scratching their heads for ideas and stuff in traffic on Interstate 405. This is when someone came up with the idea for the game, whilst fantasizing about using missiles and guns to get the other cars out of the way. Twisted Metal was a dismissive and arrogant take on the racing genre compared to other games on the market. It took the adorable things out of the picture and delivered hard-hitting action. The selling point of the game was that it was vicious and fun. The single-player mode would have you fighting through 6 stages in one of the 12 selectable vehicles. Each one of these vehicles had various strengths and weaknesses. For instance, Warthog had strong armor but low speed, while Mr. Grimm had high speed and excellent handling but poor armor. There were some kick-ass vehicles available, and we loved the likes of series icons Sweet Tooth, Lowrider Thumper, and the Pit Viper. Things started off relatively easy with the first level, in which you had to deal with a one-on-one fight. Following levels had more opponents and posed stiffer challenges. Assault on Cyberbia had as many as 8 opponents, and the final goal was to defeat the boss character Minion, who was the winner of the previous Twisted Metal competition. The destruction was fun, but you had to spend some time getting used to the controls. The handling could be tricky, and if you didn't do it right, you ran the risk of spinning out. If you played this game on the hard mode upon completion, you would unlock a secret level called Fight for Your Life, where you would be competing with 5 opponents in the arena level. Was the game flawless? It absolutely wasn't. In fact, one of the heavy criticisms leveled against it was of the backdated graphics and the lack of detailing. Besides the sloppy visuals, the game was also quite slow in its runtime, and short. You could finish it within a couple of hours. This affected the replayability of the game, though the two-player mode made up for this issue. Twisted Metal 2. If Twisted Metal was a success, Twisted Metal 2 was a ball. This game was also developed by SingleTrac and published by Sony. It is regarded as the most successful game in the series and was released in 1996 for Microsoft Windows and PlayStation. However, the graphics were slightly lacking in the Windows version in comparison to the PlayStation variant. The game is set in the aftermath of Twisted Metal, which had destroyed the city of Los Angeles. Calypso's competition now has the citizens struggling for survival, and he is wondering where to organize the next tournament, assembling 14 drivers to fight for their desired prize. This time, the battleground is enhanced. It is the entire world. The deadly battles take place in Paris, New York City, Holland, Hong Kong, Moscow, Antarctica, and Amazonia. After facing the challenge posed by Minion and dealing with the Dark Tooth boss fight, you finally get to meet Calypso in New York for the ultimate prize.
Hey, don't touch the face. Nice.
Oh, I can see all
Hold
of them
on
now.
There.
Twisted Metal was great, but the second game was in every way greater. There was a better texture and scope in this game, and even the vehicles were cooler. The physics were more realistic, and the graphics were a huge improvement from the last one. Our favorite thing about this game was the level in Paris where you could go up the Eiffel Tower, arm your vehicle, and then shoot the enemies on the ground as you fell. The gameplay was pretty simple, and you can satisfy your twisted, destructive desires through the narrative. The way you could ram into cars and cause enough damage for them to blow up was a delight for those who like things hardcore. The characters were the strongest assets of the game, with a bizarre collection of psychos, miscreants, and anti-heroes on show. The comic book style action was fun to watch, and the endings for each character were entertaining. This time around, the game came with new weapons like napalm, remote bombs, lightning, and ricochet. We love the concept of advanced attacks that were introduced for this installment, and some of the attacks like the freeze burst were simply stunning. The improved controls added to the experience, and after such amazing work, it's a shame that SingleTrac left Sony. The contractual dispute. We wouldn't say this marked the fall of the franchise, but it was certainly the beginning of the end. After Twisted Metal 2, SingleTrac stopped developing games for Sony following a contractual dispute. The job of handling the next two games was given to 989 Studios, and they didn't really impress us with the results. Twisted Metal 3. The third game is set in 1998, 2 years on from the events of Twisted Metal 2. This time, there is an interactive environment that the player can experience through the 8 levels. In the final level, you have the epic boss fight that took place in Calypso's personal blimp. It is quite a challenge because even after defeating the opponent, they kept regenerating until you destroyed the regenerating device. This was the first game in the franchise that could support up to 4 players, but such a feature was hardly enough for the company to salvage pride after a disappointing show in most other areas. One of the first things that struck us this time was the uninspired level design that dampened our high expectations following Twisted Metal 2. It might have been another entertaining addition to the series, but it was a pale shadow of the car combat mayhem that you had been used to in the previous games. 989 Studios failed to live up to the glory of SingleTrac, and all the improvements made in terms of the graphics, the vehicles, and the levels in the second game were thrown away here. The cars in particular were terrible in TM3, and the handling left a lot to be desired. The game engine was different from the first two games, and you could tell from the poor gameplay. One of the most disappointing experiences was when a vehicle rolled onto its roof and stayed that way for quite some time. All the while, you would be a sitting duck for others. It was sloppy and made no sense. The levels were ridiculously small, and there were hardly any hiding places or chances to hatch a plan or strategy. In short, this was the first time that the Twisted Metal series disappointed gamers, and it was the first indication that if the quality lagged even further, the series wouldn't last forever. Twisted Metal 4. 989 Studios was back again with the fourth game, showcasing much better work. This game was released for PlayStation, and the plot revolved around Sweet Tooth, one of the iconic characters of Twisted Metal. He had overthrown Calypso in a coup, and now he was responsible for handing the winner their desired prize. A little backstory showed how Sweet Tooth grew jealous of Calypso over time, and with the help of midget clowns, he took control of the competition. We also learned that the incredible powers of Calypso came from his ring, which consumed the souls of those defeated and increased his strength. Now Sweet Tooth had taken the ring, but was no different from Calypso when it came to cheating the winner with their wishes. The installment breathed life into the franchise, still struggling with the harsh criticism faced by the third game. Twisted Metal 4 was released a year later, a chance at redemption for 989 Studios. They fixed everything that went wrong previously, improving the levels and giving the characters badass attitudes that were missing before. We loved the fact that the battlegrounds were bigger this time, and we had a lot more weapons to pick up throughout the game. This game allowed the player to create their own vehicle, a task which was certainly fun to execute. The gnarly explosions, rock music soundtrack, and the decent graphics gave the developers back some of the lost prestige. The game involved a lot of the original characters and even added musician Rob Zombie, who featured as a playable character this time around. This was probably to appease him, having used his songs in the previous game. For many, this was the second best game in the franchise after the second, and we have to say we agree. Twisted Metal Black and Twisted Metal Head On. Not everyone in SingleTrac was happy with the dissociation from Sony. Many quit the company and formed Incognito Studios, proceeding to sign a contract with Sony. Thus, much of the original team was back, and this reunion is what caused the next installment of the franchise for PS2, Twisted Metal Black. However, the game left a lot to be desired and wasn't exactly a smashing hit. This was largely because they took risks, abandoning the tried and tested formula in an attempt to rebrand the franchise. They learned from their mistakes and tried to get back to their roots in the next game, Twisted Metal Head On. It is not surprising that many of the diehard fans consider this one to be the true sequel to Twisted Metal 2. The makers brought back the same cartoonish characters and bright colors that allowed them to strike gold in the first place. Other games in the series. Later, a new studio called Eat Sleep Play released Twisted Metal Head On with some added developments in 2008. A sequel to Twisted Metal Black, called Twisted Metal Harbor City, was cancelled, and four unreleased levels from this cancelled venture were used for the release. Twisted Metal 2012 was released for PS3, featuring three story arcs that involved Dollface, Sweet Tooth, and Mr. Grimm. This was certainly an improvement over the recent previous games. The graphics were improved a great deal, and the levels were far more exciting. The problem was that it still did not have enough to make the gamers choose it over the other exciting games available.
Who are you?
Besides these, there have been some spin-off games such as Twisted Metal Small Brawl that was developed by Incognito for a younger audience. This released in 2001 for the original PlayStation, and in the game, the full-size vehicles were replaced with tiny radio-controlled cars.
Calypso's time as the carnival's master of ceremonies came to an end! My master was ready to take his rightful place!
The fall of the Twisted Metal franchise. What does a fall of a franchise require? Not much, just a few failures and changing of hands. It all happened for Twisted Metal, and it is no surprise that the series' popularity waned over the years. The competition was cutthroat, and the content quality fell fast from the high standards they had set for themselves early on. Some of the cancelled games in the franchise could have been very interesting additions, but they never materialized. Twisted Metal Apocalypse, for instance, had a very interesting storyline on offer. In it, the characters would have been fighting each other on a post-apocalyptic wasteland, and the playable characters were supposed to range from FBI agents to Yakuza hitmen. Sweet Tooth would no longer be the masked clown, but would appear as a well-dressed African-American man with face paint. It was an idea worth exploring, but the developers suffered from cold feet and pulled the plug on the project. It is believed that the release of MotorStorm Apocalypse made them feel that the post-apocalyptic environment had been explored enough already in the vehicular gaming segment. Twisted Metal Revolution was yet another game that was being developed for PS3. This game imbibed street culture and a hip-hop influence and tried to make a funky attempt to win back fans of the franchise. They planned to implement a more realistic touch to the game and the characters. Sweet Tooth would no longer be the psychopathic clown, but a normal criminal, and a lot more realism would be introduced in the gameplay. The problem was that the environments planned in the concept art were very difficult to portray in the game. It ended up looking bland, and the poor visuals tempted the team to abandon the project.
Welcome back.
What is the future of the Twisted Metal franchise? Many of you are probably aware of the film adaptation that was cancelled, much to the disappointment of the fans. In 2012, Sony Pictures Entertainment was quite serious about bringing it to the big screen. Brian Taylor, the man who was the co-director in movies like Ghost Rider, Spirit of Vengeance, Crank, Crank High Voltage, and Gamer, was hired as the writer and director for the movie. However, the project was eventually shelved because Sony felt that the fan base had shrunk over the years, and it did not warrant the big investments required to go ahead with the project. Taylor has gone on to say that he intended something on the lines of Mad Max Fury Road, and he even revealed that he had Nicolas Cage in mind as Sweet Tooth. If Nicolas Cage was involved and Sony obliged with a budget, Taylor wouldn't bat an eyelid in his decision to make the film. As of now, we are eagerly waiting for the possibility of a TV series that is in development. The chairman and CEO of Sony Pictures Entertainment said that the project is underway, and recently in February 2021, we got the confirmation that the series is moving forward. Michael Jonathan Smith is writing the series, and Paul Wernick and Rhett Reese are helping to develop the project. We are pretty excited to see the Deadpool writers working on the show. If the series is successful, we could certainly hope for a rejuvenated franchise that would move ahead and bring back the excellence of the initial games. However, there is another thing to consider here. Will such games sell in today's gaming landscape unless significant complexities are introduced? Overall, the franchise has faced problems with aesthetics, gameplay, and storyline, and unless these issues are seriously addressed, the chances of a future game succeeding are bleak. For now, let's just keep our fingers crossed.